Hello friends, welcome to the bsptrainings.com. My name is Amit and I'm going to show you some of the features of Oracle Hybrid Planning 11.1.2.4. Although there are many new features have come in this release, but one of the most exciting feature which I like your attention to be drawn here, which is called Hybrid Planning Simplified Interface. The totally new interface. You may find there are some functionalities are overlapping if you work on Hybrid 11.1.2.3 patch 5.0. You find some look and feel are similar. Also, if you experience in Oracle Hybrid Planning cloud based version, Hybrid Planning cloud, you may find some look and feel are similar. So there are many benefits you have, but some of the benefits I like to draw over here. The first is called this interface, simplified interface is designed for the people who love to access Hybrid Planning over tablet. Second most exciting feature about it, this is performance. Now planning form use client-side scripting, therefore you definitely get a response time, a better response time, at least 33% more response time. Also the planning has dashboard has got a lot of new features including form, chart and external links and commentary. So you can display data form in chart format as well to make this data form more meaningful and easy to understand. Let me take you directly to my interface and show you. I have installed Hybrid over here in my VM player and I'm really good with the performance. The moment you log in, you find the first sample screen as you have in a previous release. I go to navigate and open my planning administrator. In a planning administration, you find that the new hyperlink over here shows simplified interface. When I click on this, a new window pop up. And if you look at the login screen, it's very similar to Hybrid Planning, planning and budgeting cloud. I'll just give the credential, username and password. And you see this is a default screen. Okay. Takes a little time to open the default screen. Now in my case, I already created sample application of Hybrid Planning called Vision, and therefore this I already initialized my Vision application. So the first window I see Vision application. When you log in first time without initializing sample application, you find this is the first screen where you have sample application, simple and advanced planning application. Simple application has a basic business rules and one plan type. Advanced planning application has got multiple plan types and complex business rules. I'll take you to the Vision application first and walk you through what are new features and look and feel have come. Click on Vision application and the first window you click on this dashboard. And I already created a couple of dashboard over here which you see. These are existing dashboard. You can click on them and look at very nice elegant view. You see you have a four division of your dashboard. The first part is your data form called cash flow forecast. I've shown over here my cash flow forecast in bar chart. Though you have a control, you can modify it, edit this. Another cash flow plan I've shown over here in a cross tabular view data form with you with the ability to change your data form layout. You can move your column to rows and rows to column. You see there's a handler up here. In addition to this, I've shown over here external link of BSP training and add a commentary over here. You can create your own dashboard and it's pretty simple. You click on create and specify what element you like to display in which part of it. So dashboard has got three sections called chart, your external link and commentary. You click on any one of them, data form, and these are different kind of view, line chart, bar chart, and there's a different commentary. So you select your data form and drag and drop place over here. I'm going to use a There are total 55 items. I'm going to use cash flow forecast over here and cash flow plan over here. So one of the cash flow forecasts I like to display with a bar chart. I change the control view over, click on this and change the view as none to bar chart. And you can give your own custom defined heading, displaying 3D chart. Other formatting feature you can also define like background color, legend, label and all. In addition this, you see, so I've got bar chart over here and here's a data form. I can add a URL over here, click on this, type a URL I'm going to use my URL http://bsptrainings.com, and you see over here I can add an additional commentary. Click on this and specify all the details of this. Is a dashboard. You can add any details over here and specify font color and change formatting related option. You can also add it. Save this, finish. You can modify the layout as well. You have got a power over here called layout option, and you can add more panels under this layout. Predefined called small, medium and large. This would be your first interface login the moment you log in. You can set this as your first login in the preferences. Click on finish. That's it. And this way you can create your own dashboard. Next you go to task list, your task, a list of tasks, the number of tasks, complete and incomplete tasks. Tasks are lined up for this week, today and future. You got very nice view of list view. In addition to it, we can see the a task list report, where I can see a pie chart over here, which says the number of tasks are complete and number of incomplete tasks. I can click on task status and task type. These are all the tasks we have: URL, data form, business rules, dimension, editor and all. So this gives you a pretty nice summary view about all the tasks you have. You can click on individual tasks and walk through. Most of the tasks are tutorial tasks. You can click on this, walk through this task, and some of them are hyperlink, and mark them as complete as you need. It's available only for desktop mode. This is a message I'm getting over here. So I open this task. It's a tutorial task. It takes me to the tutorial. I can mark this as complete and go to next. Complete and go to next and close it. Now this task is also marked as complete task. So previously we have 2%, and now it would have grown to more than, it is still 2%, tasks are completed. Then you see a data forms called plan over here. I can filter out my data form over here and say plan. The list of data forms are visible along with the instructions. You can click on data form and look at data form layout. For example, I open the data form plan in target, and you have a point of view at the top. You can select point of view and change your entity over here. We can have a data view. We can turn this into ad hoc grid, where you can change the layout as you need, or we can specify the format over here. So the list view, you have composite form, standard simple form, composite form, and you have ad hoc grid as well. Okay, in Vision application it seems we don't have any ad hoc grid. Then you have a business rule. Remaining in your Vision application, you can invoke your all business rule over here. Select your business rule and just click the call, simple call over here, invoke or call. Launch your business rule from here itself. We have a nice approval process. You can see which activities are under approved, under review, approved, rejected or post. For example, I show over here international sales. We've got many approval process. International organization, it is also not started. I'll pick up some of them, like international sales. When I open this, the current status is approval, and I can move to delegate, take ownership and originate. Take an action, approve it, and you see there are two options: change the status. In addition to this, you can move to the promotional path. Right now I can see all the annotation which is done by the administrator. Today, 17th February, it is signed off by administrator. I can click on change status and made it to approved, and change the ownership as well. So when I go to my status, I see my promotional path. I can see administrator is a current owner. You can see all the existing reports in your Vision application. So you can see HTML view and PDF view as well. I simply see Vision cash flow statement. HTML view is pretty nice view. Then you can define your point of view. You select your point of view, click on this and define your point of view, or whichever year you like to see, and continue. The cash flow report gets rendered with the current timestamp and the user as well. Console is a one centralized interface for entire planning application. You see overview, number of tasks, number of plans, number of business rules and approval hierarchy. I can see individual plan type as well and number of dimension. Remaining over here, I can import and export all the dimension, or I can create a simple new dimension over here. Create a dimension. So you may find the options are very similar to the classic applications you have. Only look and feel is different. So one centralized console where you can see entire application important aspect, including task, plans, business rules and approval hierarchy. You can go to like user preferences. In a classic application or EPM application, we have got application preferences, same option available under setting. You can define number formatting, approval process, notification, a timestamp. You can set the user-defined variables, user variables. You can define announcements, and you can add an external theme. Then you have a simple academic view over here where you can see all the instructions, like getting started for administrator, all the important points are mentioned over here. There's a one common navigator which will take you to all different part of your application in one URL. Just a single click require. For example, I like to modify my smart list. I go to navigator, click on smart list. I can see, modify or see my smart list over here. So overall, when you look at the whole interface, you find it's pretty easy for newbies, new or lazy administrator. And the look and feel are also very similar to your planning cloud. That's a quick overview about simplified interface. In subsequent video, I'm going to show you. I'll talk about each part in detail in my coming videos. So that's it for today. I'm going to stop over here. And your questions are welcome. Should you have any question, please feel free to write to us. Subscribe to our YouTube channel to access more videos. More videos of Hypion complete product suite. Thanks for joining today's session and have a great day ahead.